Not Sam.
Freddy.
What a shame.
And Ballinger's lawyer will be coming in again this morning.
Right. Well, let me know when he comes in, will you, Andrew?
Oh, will do.
Joyce looked quite ill when she arrived. Is she all right?
Well, she's had to make some difficult decisions in the past few days. As a matter of fact, she's decided to leave Norm for good.
I didn't realise it had gone so far.
Oh, we've been talking through for wee small hours.
Yes, you look pretty tired yourself.
Morning, Joan.
Yes. I tried to persuade her to take a few days off, but she won't have a bar.
Look, I'm sorry about this, but I'm going to... Well, I'm going
to... Come on, I haven't got time to stand around chatting all day.
Well, Governor's orders, I'm going to have to search you.
What are you talking about?
Well, Mrs. Reynolds has decided...
Oh, see, and exactly how long has this been going on?
What's the problem, Miss Ferguson?
Oh, there's no problem, Governor. I don't object to being searched, but I do object to being singled out.
No one's being singled out. Every office has been searched this morning.
Including the Governor.
See. Well, I have always said that these are the sort of security levels we should have at Wentworth.
Come to my office and I'll give you the supply form.
Well, come on. I want a cup of coffee before I start.
Well, I'd better have a look at your bag and coat.
Oh, for heaven's sake!
Wentworth Detention Centre, can I help you?
All right.
Yes, go ahead.
I've been doing a lot of thinking in the last few days, and I've learned one or two very important things about myself.
And what about Norman?
Oh, I've told him I want a divorce. I've told him that it's all over.
Well, I hear.
Well, I had to, Mervyn, because... Well, I just had to.
You're a very remarkable woman, Joyce. That must have taken a lot of courage.
Thanks.
I don't suppose you wouldn't,
I suppose it'd be all right if we had a night out now, if you'd like to, Mervyn.
Oh, Joyce!
Oh, do you mind? Other people have got to use this room too, you know. So I suppose we're lucky you're not doing it in front of the prisoners.
I don't think you understand, Miss Ferguson.
Sure, there's a lot of people who don't. Your husband, for one.
Just get back to my rounds.
I told you I'd give you a day out, you remember, before I went back to Wentworth. And one thing about me, I always keep my word.
When you remember.
When I remember. Yes, I know. I remembered now, haven't I? Oops.
Mind the step. Oh, are we there yet? Oh, nearly broken my neck twice.
Sadie Grimshaw, will you stop? You're whinging.
I'll bet the whole village is looking at us. My reputation as a sober and respectable citizen has gone right down the plug hole since you moved in.
Oh, no one can see you. I bet you've been at those liquor chocolates again.
I have not.
You're always the same when you've had one over the eight.
Well, if you're going to be personal.
All right, now stop your grizzling. We've arrived. Now, you are about to have one of your lifelong ambitions fulfilled. There you are, Sadie. What do you reckon?
What is it?
Well, it's not a bloody go-kart, is it?
What's it for?
Our day out. We're going to the races in style. I've even got a couple of bottles of your favourite medicine in there.
Auntie, oh, you shouldn't have. Oh, but you can't drive, and nor can I.
You don't credit me with the sense that I was born with. Don't say anything. Just get in, sit back and think of Tyrone Power.
I don't get it. This morning he's cracking a mental and now he's carrying on as though he's won a million or something.
I told you, I'm not talking to you after the trouble you caused me last night. I've now had to go for a new dorm.
Only said what I saw.
Come along, girlies, a bit more work, eh? Sooner we get these breakfast things washed, the sooner we start on tea.
We haven't had lunch yet.
That's what I said, lunch. Oh, yeah, we all work hard. I'm going to make some of our special chocolate kisses for us all later.
Get them boiled lollies, I guess. Nerve the perv strikes again. What a nerd.
What was that?
Oh, just tell him Will here about a song I just heard, eh, Will?
Now, don't drag me into it and don't call me Will. Willie's bad enough. Did you say to chip these or mash them?
Whatever you think best, Joyce.
She's not Joyce. She's Willie. Wilhelmina?
Wilhelmina.
You must remember Joyce. She's one of the screws in and out of here every 10 seconds.
Of course I know who Joyce, Mrs. Barry is. And if you're careful, I suggest she puts you on one of those charge things.
Oh, don't do that. I reckon she'd do just about anything you asked her.
Lexi?
No, probably. I reckon she'd even give up a seat in the bus for you.
That's enough of that. Now, go back to work.
No, dead set, sir. She'd probably even eat that rubbery pie you keep making, long as there was sauce, of course.
I'll have you know Mrs. Barry's a very happily married woman.
Oh, yeah? Well, I reckon if your luck holds out, she might even give that husband of hers a shove for you. Bet you fancy that, eh?
Shh, keep your voice down. No one must know.
Eh?
In heaven's name, did you find out about it anyway?
You mean it's true?
Mr. Pringle.
Mmm, good quality stuff. Too good for this place.
You said the contact would give me one package, Ballinger. What's in the second one?
Let's have a look, shall we? Might find a big surprise.
I can do without surprises. I was searched this morning and came
I'm
very
close... I'm sure you're far too clever to get caught.
Oh, there'll be no danger of that, because there won't be any more deliveries.
We'll see. Why, what a coincidence. It's exactly what I expected to find.
You said I was only bringing in marijuana.
Did I say that?
That wasn't part of the agreement.
Oh, I think it was. It's a terrible thing, of course. But I think Myra's had a hell of a time recently. Not a word from any of her friends, not even a boyfriend. A girl can get so depressed when something like that happens. Even suicidal. I believe an overdose of heroin is a very unpleasant affair.
I think I'll insist we have our meetings out here in future. The federal police have turned that interview room into a very unprivate place. Have you checked your cell, by the way?
Ceiling to floor. No sign of a bug anywhere.
Be careful what you say, all the same.
I've had some very unambiguous chats with one of the screws, the one who did the pickups for me. She wouldn't have said what she did if they'd been listening.
Perhaps.
Well, what's the news from Arnie?
He suggests now is perhaps the time for you to pass on two more names to the police. Sullivan and Briggs.
Two more from Lionel's stable.
Mr. Fellows is not going to be pleased at all.
Well, since I left him to marry Arnie, there's been, how could one put it, a slight rift.
You'll need these, by the way.
No, thanks.
I still can't understand why you want a prison officer to bring in your drugs. You got those that came in your table lamp, didn't you?
Yes, I did. But this way, I now have the screw under my control. I'll probably never have to use it, but I'd look pretty silly trying to blackmail a table lamp.
I just cracked up. How do you spell a door in there?
They'll have to wear blindfolds when they're doing it.
Are you sure they're actually living together?
Of course I bloody am. Look, how do you spell a door in
A-D-O-O-R-E-L-E. What did Reno say?
Oh, nothing. Except she wanted to see him in her office. When he came back, he just told me to bugger off to the laundry. Pity, because I have quite a few jokes.
Collins? You're being put on kitchen duty to replace Patterson.
Oh, I've just sat down. I'm in the middle of a line.
I'm sorry, but no one will get lunch unless Mr. Pringle can get staff who can get on with their work without causing trouble.
Got the message, Mrs. Barry. On my way.
Carry on, ladies.
Oh, Mrs. Barry, you dropped something.